and we begin our vigil for the Easter Triduum by welcoming you in the name of love. Thank you for allowing me into your heart on this very special feast. It is one of the greatest Christian festivals. But before we celebrate the resurrection of the Jesus, the barefoot Galilean, it would be nice to be present with Magdalena by the tomb and to be there when the angels come and release the stone from the entrance to the tomb. But first, if you have a candle handy, I would like to invite you to light your candle for a very, very special intention. And the intention is for world peace, for global peace, and for every child of God, regardless of their belief or none, that they will come back to their heart, that they will come back to Gaia, Mother Earth, that they will embrace our beloved Earth's mother and the animal kingdom, and that they will become peacemakers, kingdom builders for the Supreme. So we dedicate this simple flame to a loving Father, Mother God, in thanksgiving for bringing to us Jesus, the barefoot Galilean, who shed his life for us, who gave his last breath for us. Let us unite as one loving family as we come in service to God, as we come in service to light, as we come in service to peace. So let us now just be still. Let us be still as we call on the nature spirits and we embrace this beautiful shamanic chant. Let us just relax now and call on all the nature spirits of the animal kingdom to join us. Be still and allow our hearts become opened to the love of the nature spirits. Let us sense their joy. Thank you. Mother Earth is joining us now, and she's allowing the nature spirits and the angels of the angelic kingdom and the animal kingdom to come, to be with us so that we celebrate together as beings of love, as beings of the Supreme. And as we come into our sacred space, let our hearts not be saddened, for the Christ is about to rise from the dead. But more importantly, he is about to rise in you, in your spirit, and release you as a beloved of the Supreme. Let us join all faiths and none. Let us join the whole Christian family around the world, many of whom have already celebrated the resurrection, and some have yet to celebrate it. So let us unite. Let us celebrate the rebirthing of the Holy Spirit in our heart. Let us be still now, and let us call on the messengers of God. Let us call on Michael, Gabriel, Raphael, Metatron, Israfil, Moroni, Melchizedek, Aziel, the whole company of heaven. And let us call on the great teachers, the Lord Buddha, Vishnu, Ganesh, Krishna, our brother Gandhi, Sri Chinmoy, Francis of Assisi, Claire, Teresa of Avila, Bernadette Subaru. Let us call on Mia Baba, Rumi, Osho. Let us call on the Ascended Masters, Lord Maitreya, Lord Kutumi, Lord Elmoha, Lord Dwalkal, Lord Babaji, Lord Saint-Germain, Lady Nada, Lady Portia, Lady Athena, Mother Mary, Lady Magdalena, and our beautiful Gaia and Kuan Yin. As we sit here, let us feel the healing touch of the Supreme around us. And using our gift of free will, let this be our gift to the Supreme, that we are calling on the resurrected Christ to come into our life, to come into our heart, and reawaken the spirit of unity and peace within us. Let us now be still and just sense the love of a forgiving, compassionate, reverent, respectful Father, Mother, God. And as we breathe in, let us breathe in that love from all the beings of light who are now around us, who are with us, who are here, who are with you. And in your out-breath, release a blessing. A blessing to our Father, Mother, God, Supreme, for the great act of love that they demonstrated for us, for you and for me, in the giving of their beloved Son, Jesus, to be a sacrificial offering of love, just be still. And I would like you to walk with me now on a short journey from Golgotha, from the hill where the three crosses stand, and there's a slight wind blowing. It is Saturday late evening, and there's a chill in the air, and you can smell smoke from the various fires around the hill of Golgotha. The disciples of Jesus have returned, and they're sat there in shock, in mourning. Many bystanders have come because their curiosity got the better of them. And as you walk, you come to a clearing, and there you see before you a rock face. And you see a stone in front of that rock. There is a tomb behind this, where they have laid the Jesus, the Christ, who said he was the Messiah. And you come, you light a fire. But first you go to get some sticks and woods from the little tarn below, and having lit your fire, you start to feel warm, and you sit quietly in reverence and respect, and you sense the presence of God. You can't explain it, but in your heart is vibrating with joy, and you don't know why yet, but you know something is going to happen. Your heart is being prepared to receive the resurrected Christ. Just be still now and allow yourself to become warm by the little fire. And around this fire, we are joined by Nirmala and our brother Kedar. We're joined by William, Eleanor and Elizabeth, Miriam, Snowcloud. We're joined by Sue. We're joined by the brothers and sisters of other faiths, because they respect that Jesus was a holy man, and they've come to support us in our mourning, in our grief. And we sit around this fire in silence, praising the one God. Though we are of different faiths at this fire, we all have one thing in common. We are all children of the one loving God. And that makes us brothers and sisters. We are here. We are here to give thanks to God for our life, for our abundance. Let us be still. Let us be still at this sacred fire, the first fire of Easter. Let us look into the flames, for we shall see something there. There is a presence in this fire. It is the Spirit of God. Sense the power of the Spirit of God coming from the flames of the fire, and they are touching us. We are being reawakened to the sound of a trumpet. There is a trumpet sound coming, and before us stands two angels of light, two magnificent beings of light, dressed in white, with golden hair, and they're standing by the cave, the tomb. We are dazzled, and we look to see what is happening. And suddenly we see them removing the stone to the entrance of the tomb. And there is a ray of light bursting from the tomb. And it shoots from the tomb up into the heavens. And the angels have gone. And we go running to the tomb. And we notice it is empty. Jesus is not there. He is gone. The angels have taken him. But there is a fragrance in the tomb, a beautiful fragrance of the spikenard that Magdalena used on the body of Jesus. And we see the towel that they wrapped his sacred body in, the shroud they call it. And we can see the imprints of the crown of thorns from the blood. We can see the markings of his head and shoulders and his spine. We can see blood halfway down where they pierced his side. We can see marks on the hands from the nails and on his feet. And we decide to sit in the sacred tomb. We sit in silence, and there is great reverence, be still now, and allow the peace, of this tomb touch you now. In this tomb, something is happening. Our hearts are beating with love. Our hearts are on fire with love. And yes, we can hear the thunder. We can see the sheets of lightning. And we can hear a chorus of angels singing. The Beloved has risen. The Christ, the Son of God, has risen. Be still. Be still. And now as dawn is breaking, something is happening outside. We hear footsteps. Yes, we can see a woman coming, running. Running. It is the beloved Magdalena. Her hair is blowing in the wind. She looks to be in shock. And she comes running to the tomb. And trips and falls, with her hands coming through the tomb, and she's in shock. Her beloved Jesus is gone. He is not here. She is devastated. She leans over and cries, sobbing her heart out, for they have taken her beloved. She's unconsolable. And we can see this, but she cannot see us. And she lies there, sobbing and sobbing, because they have taken her Lord, and no one told her. And then she hears a voice. Mary, why weepest thou? And she looks startled and around to see who is it. She stands up. She hears it again. Mary, Mary, why are you weeping? And she looks shocked. She realizes it is the beloved. It is the Lord. It is her master, Jesus. She goes running to hold him, to trust it is him. And he says, do not touch me. I have yet to arise in glory. I am not an apparition. I am Jesus. And I love you. I come to you because you gave me your love. You trusted me. And out of love for you, I come to you first. Not to my mother, not to Peter or John, but I come to you. Do not weep now, but go and tell my disciples, those who fell asleep, who couldn't cope, who ran away like so many do today when I call them to service and ministry. They give in when things don't go their way. Tell them, I have risen. I have risen. And the Master looks into the tomb as Mary runs scurrying over the hills to go to see the disciples. Jesus walks into the tomb where he laid, and he looks at you. And he says, I have risen for you. I have risen for you. I have risen that you will be free. It is I. It is I. Be still. Standing before you on this Easter morn, and he is resplendent in his glorified body, and he looks at you and me, and he calls us by name. Will you follow me now? Will you follow me? I have risen, but not yet. I have yet to go to my Father in heaven. But I want you to remember this time, and I want you to celebrate my love for you. Be still in your heart and allow me bless you. Allow me reawaken within you the gifts of my love. For I called you by your name, and you did not run away. I come to you. A as a groom to his bride, and I anoint you with my love. Treasure that love, for it is the pearl of great price. Be still and believe that I have risen. I have risen for you. to conclude. There are some beautiful words that are to be shared for this day, and I would like to share them with your heart, a gift from my heart to the Christ, the risen Christ, in you. Taste and see that I am good, said Jesus. The more intimately you experience me, the more convinced you become of my goodness. I am the living one who sees you and longs to participate in your life. I am training you to find me in each moment and to be a channel of my loving presence. Sometimes my blessings come to you in mysterious ways, through pain and trouble. At such times you can know my goodness only through your trust in me. Understanding will fail you, but trust will keep you close to me. Thank me for the gift of my peace, a gift of such immense proportions that you cannot fathom its depth or its breadth. When I appeared to my disciples after the resurrection, it was peace that I communicated first of all. I knew this was their deepest need, to calm their fears and clear their minds. I also speak peace to you, for I know your anxious thoughts. Listen to me. Tune out other voices so that you can hear me more clearly. I designed you to dwell in peace all day, every day. Draw near to me. Receive my peace. Receive my peace. Receive my peace. My dear brothers and sisters, I thank you for joining me. And together let us celebrate the resurrexit dixit. The Christ has risen. Feel his rebirthing and resurrection in your heart. And take from this vigil the love that the Christ has for you. And take his peace and share it with others so that they may know that he is risen and that he calls you and me to be ambassadors of his peace. I wish you a blessed Easter. I wish that your hearts will become inflamed by the love that the Supreme has for each one of us. Namaste. Shalom and Shalom Pax et Bonum. Om Shanti. Solo di Caritas. Peace. Alleluia. Alleluia. He is risen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord Supreme. Alleluia.